Hello friends, a warm welcome to yet another interesting session on instrumentation and control in power plant industries. In our previous session, we have covered the segregation of various types of flow meters based on their principle of measurement like velocity type flow meter, variable area flow meter, differential pressure flow meter and mass flow meter. In this video, we will be discussing about velocity type flow meters in details. We have already discussed velocity type flow meters are based on the principle that flow is directly proportional to velocity. However, the method of this velocity measurement may differ from type to type. So, based on the method of velocity measurement, we have further classified this velocity type flow meters into four categories. One is magnetic flow meter, or electromagnetic flow meter, or MEG flow meter. These are based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Second type is ultrasonic flow meters that utilizes the Doppler's effect, which means the variation in sound frequency is calibrated to calculate the fluid velocity. Third type is turbine flow meters, in which the mechanical energy of fluid is used to rotate a rotor placed in the fluid path. The RPM of the rotor is measured using proximity switch. This measured RPM is proportional to the fluid velocity. And the last type is vortex flow meters. In this type of flow meters, an obstruction is placed in fluid path. This obstruction is called vortex shadow. Due to this obstruction, vortices are generated, and a vortex detector is installed to measure the vortices generated. The number of vortices generated are directly proportional to the fluid velocity and thus the fluid flow rate. So, velocity type flow meters are basically four types: electromagnetic flow meters, ultrasonic, turbine flow meter, and vortex flow meter. So let's discuss in detail how does an electromagnetic flow meter measures fluid flow rate. From outside it looks like this one, blue one. On both sides we have flanges. These flanged connections are for upstream and downstream pipeline connection. Now, as the name itself clears that it is a device measuring flow and is based on electromagnets. We know there are two kind of magnets. One are permanent magnet, second is electromagnet. Permanent magnets are basically ferromagnetic materials such as iron, nickel and cobalt, which has the property of attracting other pieces of these materials. Their property of magnetism is not lost throughout time. So these are called permanent magnets. Another type is electromagnet, which is that means an electricity or electric current is used to generate magnetic field. The magnetic field disappears when the current is turned off. Such type of magnets are usually consist of wire wound around a coil. So our electromagnetic flow meter works on electromagnets. That is, we provide electric current to the magnets installed here. Next is, we know these are based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So let's discuss about Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Say there are two magnets, this one NS, they are placed such that one magnet south pole is facing the other magnet's north pole. Thus a magnetic field is generated between them. Now a conductor is moving in and out in this magnetic field in perpendicular direction. If we connect a voltmeter across this conductor, we can observe a voltage deflection as the conductor moves in and moves out of the magnetic field. So same principle work, based on the same principle our synchronous generators and DC motors work. So we understood that it works only when a conductor moves through a magnetic field. In our electromagnetic flow meters, we have electromagnets which are connected to electrical power source. We have magnets, these are connected to electrical power source, and that power source makes them electromagnets, and magnetic field is generated basically in that particular cross section which is between these two electromagnets. Now, in order to this Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction to be fulfilled, we have electromagnets, magnetic field is generated, but the thing missing is conductor moving perpendicular to the magnetic field. And in this particular case of electromagnetic flow meters, the fluid flowing through the pipeline serves as a conductor. So the basic condition is the fluid must be conductive. Here the fluid flowing through the pipe acts as a conductor. So the main requirement is it works only on conductive fluids. That is, the conductivity of fluid must be greater than 5 microsiemens per centimeter. Only then it will work. Means the fluid should have positive and negative ions in it, like our salt NaCl, which has sodium positive ions and chlorine negative ions. It could be calcium carbonate with calcium positive and carbonate negative ions. Whereas if the salts are removed from water to produce demineralized water, then its conductivity is nearly zero, and electromagnetic flow meters cannot be used for measuring DM water. The flow meter will always show zero reading irrespective of whatever DM water flow is flowing through the pipeline. The flow meter is connected to external power source. Basically, it works on electromagnets. So to make these electromagnets, we need external power source, which is generally 220 volt AC. It will generate magnetic field in between the electromagnets. The ions, basically cations and anions present in the conductive fluid, will split and move towards their oppositely charged electrodes. We can see this in this right top side diagram, where fluid is flowing, conductive fluids having cation and anions. Two electrodes are placed in the magnetic field. Cations are moving toward one electrode and anions are moving towards another electrode. But while coming out of the pipe of the flow meter, they are again getting combined. So as the magnetic field is cut by the conductive fluids, a voltage is generated, which is sensed by the electrodes and given to the connected transmitter. This transmitter is further calibrated to give 4 to 20 milliampere corresponding to the voltage generated. This 4 to 20 milliampere is transmitted to DCS or PLC to show the volumetric flow. The voltage generated is directly proportional to velocity of the positive and negative ions in the fluid. Thus, voltage is proportional to conductive fluid velocity, and velocity we know is directly proportional to flow rate. Therefore, we can say that voltage generated is directly proportional to the fluid flow rate. Further, we know this measured flow is volumetric flow. It is affected by pressure and temperature variations. Thus, at DCS, and it is advisable to compensate the received raw volumetric reading with temperature and pressure. Basically, each instrument in the field is calibrated under certain operating pressure and temperature reference conditions, which we can check from its calibration certificate done by the erection or commissioning engineer. So the actual temperature and pressure of the pipelines are also measured, and thus raw value of the flow measurement is compensated for the temperature and pressure variations with respect to the calibrated reference values. Moreover, so it has the its installation and commissioning is complicated, so few precautions have to be taken while installing these flow meters. First one is we have to check the flow direction. Check the arrow sign on the flow meter. We can see on in this figure that the air there is a mark on this flow meter. This tail of this arrow is its upstream side and head is its downstream side. So the flow direction shown on the flow meter has to be matched with the process flow direction. If we connect it in the reverse direction, then the readings will not be accurate. Second thing is, the fluid should be turbulence free. That is, it works with laminar flow. Suppose just close to this flow meter, we have a T joint or an elbow where another stream of fluid is mixing with the main stream. Then at that particular moment, there would be turbulence. And if that turbulence comes directly in contact with our flow meter, then the reading would be inaccurate. Therefore, there is an upstream and downstream straight pipe length requirement for the installation of this flow meter. And that we can easily calculate that upstream and downstream straight pipe length requirement. Like if the flange diameter of this flow meter is D mm, then upstream we need 5D and downstream we need 3D straight lengths. So means if flange diameter is 100 mm, then upstream we will be requiring 500 mm and downstream we will be requiring 300 mm straight pipe length to avoid any turbulent flow. Beyond this required straight length, you can install elbow, T joint and whatever. This will not affect the flow measurement. Third requirement is that the line should be fully filled. In case of partially filled pipeline, the measured output will be incorrect. Thus, during horizontal installation, electromagnetic flow meters are installed with U-shaped arrangement so that the line is always fully filled at this particular cross section where flow meter is installed. If we are installing it in vertical direction, then the flow should be from bottom to top. The advantages of electromagnetic flow meters are, it is independent of viscosity, density and temperature. As there is no obstruction, so literally no pressure loss, it can measure large range, suitable for viscous and slurry, suitable for high and low flow. It has certain disadvantages too, like it can be used only for conductive fluids. Means as we already discussed, it cannot be used for demineralized water. Second thing is, its installation and commissioning is complicated, but that could be solved. Like we discussed, its upstream and downstream straight length requirements, its laminar flow requirements, that can be solved. And its position, that fluid should be always filled in this like U-shaped horizontal and from entry from bottom to top, so that this installation problems can be resolved. Another thing is, dirty and sticky substances may stick to the electrode and cause wrong readings. So friends, this was all about electromagnetic flow meter principle, its application, its limitation and its specific installation requirements. Hope I am able to clear the concept well. We will meet you in our next video with other flow meters in details. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Have a nice day. Bye.